Good morning, everyone. I'm Jiawei, PhD candidate in Mechanical Engineering Department. Currently, I'm working with Professor Sumasi Krishnan in the field of renewable energy technology, specifically PV technology. U.S. Department of Energy has launched a Sunshot initiative to reduce the PV cost, panel cost by 70% by the year of 2020. To achieve this goal, low-cost PV technology such as dye-sensitized solar cells play an important role. Dye-sensitized solar cells have applications ranging from simple solar-powered army jackets to large applications such as building integrated photovoltaics. In fact, due to the development in molecular engineering, transparent colored thin films have been introduced, which enhances the aesthetic value of the building. My research focuses on both theoretical and experimental studies on dye-sensitized solar cells with two main objectives. One, improve the device efficiency over 15% to compete with silicon-based solar cells. Two, enhance the thermal stability at high temperature operating conditions using gel electrolyte. My preliminary work has shown that the diffusion force dictates electron flow in dye-sensitized solar cells, whereas in conventional p-n junctions, electrical force dominates. These results have been validated by experimental data. I carried out these experiments at South Dakota State University at their Advanced PV Technology Center. Tin oxide nanofibers with a diameter about 200 to 300 nanometers were fabricated by electrospinning process. These nanofibers induce strong light scattering and therefore can significantly enhance light harvesting. This study has established important relations between cell performance and cell design, as well as materials parameters. This study provides an important guide to future high-efficient dye-sensitized solar cells. Results have shown that the presence of tin oxide nanofibers could significantly increase the device efficiency by twofold, mainly because of effective light scattering and charge transport. These results have been presented in conferences, including one international renewable energy conference in Spain. And the experimental studies, the work has been communicated to the American Journal of Materials Chemistry. I believe with consistent efforts, dye-sensitized solar cells could be a reliable electrical power supplier in the future. Thank you very much.